or something, I tell you. I just lived right down the street. Just shook the house. Oh. I tell you, this is the worst part of the day for me. All right, this is my hardest part. I'm going to the family. Are you the Brown family?
Yes, we are.
Can we get you to come and view the body, please? Can you tell me what's going on? What's going on? What's going on? Beth, what's wrong with Mom? Why is Mom crying? What's going on? Can anyone tell me what's going on? Why are y'all here? Why am I here? What's going on? Can you tell me what's going on, ma'am? What's going on? I'll tell you. You know, this is the hardest part of this job. I wonder every day when I look at these young people, I just wonder if somebody told them about the Lord. Mom, dad, friend. You know, they were crying so hard. And I just wonder if they were even just told about the goodness of the Lord. My heart just goes out to them. You know, this is just a hard time for everybody. I just pray she knew who he was. All right. A hard time. Ma'am, what are you talking about? What do you mean a hard time? What is going on? Sir, can you please tell me what's going on? I'm trying to think. I don't understand what happened. We send our children off daily. We don't know what they're going to run into. We just want to know that they're with the Lord and that they know him and the pardons of their sins. Another job done.
Another job done. What was she talking about? What happened? I don't understand what happened. Gotta think and try and remember. Think. I think it's slowly coming to me now. In fact, it's coming to me like as if it was real. I remember yesterday, I was at work. Saw that new movie,
that paranormal.
Yes.
Yeah.
So that's got me really on edge.
Did you want to set up a camera in your own room?
No, that's okay. That's all right. I need a man to take care of that.
Oh. I have the perfect man.
Are you about to preach to me again? Come on now, you just walked in the door.
Okay.
What are you doing tonight?
Tonight, I don't know. I don't know for sure.
Well, you know, we're having a Bible study tonight.
A Bible study?
Yeah, we have one every Friday.
Friday night?
Yeah.
A Bible study?
It's only like for an hour.
For an hour. What time does it start?
7.
7 o'clock. Yeah. So y'all should be done by 8 o'clock?
Maybe 8:30, depending on how the Spirit leads. But yeah, about that time.
I'll have to think about it. You know what? It's not thinking about it. I'll be there.
Oh, great!
Just be looking for me, okay?
Okay.
I am going to be in the back row, last seat, in a red dress, behind the clock.
Behind the clock?
Behind the clock.
Okay. I might be a little hard, but okay. And you remember where the church is, right?
Yep. 903 South George Washington Boulevard.
902.
902?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
I think you're trying to pull my leg.
I'm not. I've been there all the time.
Okay. 902 South George Washington Boulevard.
Yes.
Courtney!
I'm good. How are y'all doing?
Doing good.
Ooh, y'all came on time.
How are doing?
Yes.
Hi, Miss Beth Ashenay, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you doing?
All right.
You know, I was telling Courtney we're having a Bible study tonight if you guys want to come out.
Oh, uh-uh. I can't come out.
It's only going to be like an hour if you guys want to come.
Ooh, should I get hot?
Well, maybe another week you guys could come out.
Maybe. I'm going.
You're going.
Yep, I'm going to be there. I told her I'm going to be in the back row, last seat, behind the clock in my red dress.
Dress.
Yeah, you love my red dress.
Yeah, I know that red dress.
You
I
know.
Know.
Which one. Mm-hmm. Why don't you go and get us some wires? Can you do that for
That'd
us?
That'd probably
please?
Be good. Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Thank you.
Bye.
Girl, you know you ain't going to no Bible study.
In that red dress, I know you ain't going to no Bible study.
What? Man, y'all know. Y'all know how she is. Just every time I see her, she's asking me to go to church, Bible study, a revival.
Church.
No, y'all know I'm not going to Bible study, but what are we doing?
We're going to the club. Same city.
Yeah. Tonight.
That's right. I couldn't remember which club it was.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. And that starts at what time?
10.
Okay. I got it this time.
You got it
I'll
this
be
time.
There.
Are you sure this time?
Yes, I'm positive.
No, okay.
This time I will.
This time. I had
to
make sure last time.
Mm-hmm. Now, who's the DJ that's going to be there?
DJ Holiday.
Ah!
She is off the chain. You know she is off the chain.
Again.
Hey.
Thank you.
You guys going to a club?
No, we're going
to a book club.
Oh.
Yeah.
To a book
really?
Club.
What book are you guys reading?
Sin City.
Oh, is it about how sin is bad and you shouldn't do it?
Shh, don't
talk about it. Sure. So, talk about the book. That's the whole point of the book club.
No.
You're not supposed to tell the secrets of the book.
Oh.
Do you want to go to the book club?
What time is it?
10 o'clock.
Probably not. Honestly, I'm going to be really tired because we have choir practice early in the morning. And our choir director, she expects us to be on time, so.
Are you on time all the time?
I try to be.
Come on now, look at her. Of course you're going to be on time.
I guess.
Y'all better hurry up before the boss goes.
Oh, yeah, she doing inspections today.
You know, every time people come around, she likes to come around.
Pin me on my belly.
Gotcha.
Got it.
So now you are going to come out to Bible study, right?
Yes, 7 o'clock, 903 South George Washington Boulevard.
902.
I don't know why I always get that mixed up.
Well, I'll give you a heads up. We are going to be studying about Job, so you can kind of read.
Job. I love Job. Oh my goodness, Job is my buddy.
Okay, so you know about Job.
Yep, I know about Job. J-O-B.
job.
Job.
No, not exactly.
What?
No.
J-O-B. Isn't that how his name is spelled?
It is, but it's
J-O-B,
pronounced
job.
Job.
Well, I pronounce it job.
Well, maybe if you read a little bit beforehand, you'll learn a little about it.
I think I will.
Sounds good.
Okay.
So we'll see you tonight, 7 o'clock?
7 o'clock, back row, last seat, behind the clock in my red dress.
At 9:02.
9:02.
Okay.
South George Washington Boulevard.
Okay.
I will be there.
Okay.
All right.
I hope to see you. All
raise
right.
them.
See you later.
All right. I'm not going to no Bible study. I gotta go get ready to go to the club. Gotta go get my hair done, my nails done.
All right, y'all, let's get this club on and popping. Let me see them hands up! Woo! Oh yeah! In the U.S.!
Thank you.
All right. Since y'all ain't moving, we're going to slow it down for all the players out there. Come grab you a sexy honey. Let's see what they got.
Whew. See, you know what? This is my last time coming out here with you.
I can't believe it.
What is this?
It's very disappointing.
They ran out.
Last time I came out with you, it was... I'm not coming to Sin City no more.
It's Beecher's club.
Beecher, why didn't you suggest this club?
I don't know.
Looked like she'd been drinking before she even got here.
All right, y'all. Go find that special lady, young man. Let's go.
Well, I gotta go. Because ain't nothing going on. It's about time. Can I do one of those? You're a sweetheart.
All right, get your Mac on.
Girl, you better go.
How
you doing?
I'm doing good. How are you?
Okay. I want to introduce myself. My name is Jerry West.
Off to look at Pippin, talking to Courtney. Pippin. Alright, y'all, we're about to close in 5 minutes.
Oh, they're about to close.
Oh, yeah?
Where'd you park at?
Last call for alcohol!
Where'd you park?
I parked in the front.
You parked in the front?
Yeah, I parked in the front.
Well, I parked in the back.
Alright.
I'll meet you in the parking lot.
Okay.
Bye, ladies.
All right, y'all. Sin City is now closing. Thank you for coming to Sin City. You ain't got to go, but you got to get up out of here.
Again? By myself? These people need to learn some timing. Always late. That's why they don't get promoted around here. If I was the manager, I'd be firing some people.
Hey, Courtney.
Girl, every time you walk in here, you be scared of it.
You might want to check why you're still on edge. That's all I'm going to say. So, missed you last night.
You missed me?
Yeah.
I didn't miss you.
Really?
Yeah. I was there.
Were you?
Mm-hmm.
And what part did you like?
The part of what?
At the Bible study.
Oh, the Bible study. You want me to sit? You really want to know what part I like?
Well, because I didn't see you at the Bible study.
Okay, let me tell you the part that I like. I like the part where the preacher got up and he was walking like this.
Now,
and he was saying, hold up. He was saying this. Henda, you need to get up. Yes. That's the part that I like.
Always gives me you were at the right place. Because we just had a Bible study, not a sermon last night.
Oh, my goodness. Your address is 903.
No,
South
902.
Oh.
You're at 903, you're across the street.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, was that the Presbyterian church?
I didn't know the Presbyterians got down like that.
Oh, my goodness. I was at the wrong church.
Well, that's okay. Maybe you come next week. Maybe Sunday.
Maybe Sunday. You know, I'll be there on Sunday. 902 South George Washington Boulevard.
At 10 o'clock.
10 o'clock. I will be there in my purple dress on Sunday.
Okay. And you know, it's no pressure if you're not able to come. We just want everybody to feel welcome.
Oh, I do feel welcome. I feel welcome right now.
Good, good. You did miss a really good lesson, though. We talked about Joe.
Joe. J-O-B.
Courtney!
It's about time y'all got here.
One more time. What's your name?
Beth.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
I
didn't
forget.
I write that down. I know, it's
kind of
hard.
No, not really. I just be forgetting. So, how are you doing?
Oh, I'm doing fabulous. You know why? Let me tell you why you're so high up on the 81st floor.
Don't be climbing. Okay, right?
It's because of all y'all hot breath people be breathing on each other.
No.
Was saying that last night.
Really?
Book club.
Oh, that's right.
Right. Yeah. Hot Cheetos, hot breath.
Oh, okay. Understandable. Yeah.
Speaking of hot, I need some coffee.
Okay.
Can you go?
You hot and you want some coffee?
Can you go give me some coffee, please?
Sure, no problem.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I need a coffee. Oh. To wake me up.
To wake you up.
Y'all kept me at that book club too long last night.
I seen your, what's his name?
You know.
That dude you was talking to.
Mister, I'm gonna buy you a drink.
You was so hot.
Mm-hmm. What?
You know what guy? You know that guy with silky silk brain?
Yeah. Y'all talking about him?
Yeah.
My boo?
Yeah. Hello, what about him?
Well, he's about 6 foot.
She got jealous.
Right.
Okay, that's all right. We seen him take you home last night.
He didn't take me home.
Oh, y'all didn't go home.
No, we didn't go.
This
is what happened. We met up in the parking lot. He took me to IHOP, and we shared all-you-can-eat pancakes.
Well, you know, I got a meeting with the boss real quick, so I'll be right back, y'all.
Okay.
Right back, y'all.
All
right.
Teacher, I'm tired of you walking around. You are fired.
I'm fired.
What? Thank you, Beth. Don't you think you might want to go too before they fire you?
Oh, no, y'all. Did y'all not just hear that? I got fired. Fired. That short little thing, you should get fired me. Are you serious?
Girl, you shouldn't.
I'm going to go to play down, and y'all going to come with me, and just boom. I got when the cold police come out to me and everything. I'll see y'all later. Shoot.
Call me. Thanks for my coffee, though.
Yeah.
You're going to give it a few seconds. I wouldn't even give it a few seconds. I'd hurry up and go.
I
can't
imagine.
She's
probably
going to
be back there. She's just going to. All right. Done, guys.
She's from the 81st floor.
Touch. Yeah. I'm seeing. Well, you know, like I was saying, I really think you would have enjoyed this.
I
was saying last night.
Really?
Yeah. Have you ever heard about Job at all? Did you read a book like I told you?
You know I come from the church, Beth.
I know.
You know I know about Job, for real.
Okay. So, you remember how he got to go through trials to see what was going to happen, and, you know, he lost his wife and his kids and everything he owned?
Mm-hmm. I know how that feels.
And then his friend said it was his fault. Yeah. But you know, the good thing is, there's a happy ending to that story.
Yeah, it is a happy ending.
Yes, ma'am.
It is a happy ending to that story. You know, I've been sitting back and I've been wondering, where is my happy ending? You know, everything that I've been through, Beth, I don't think you even realize what I've been through.
Well, why don't you tell me?
Well, you know, I was married for 5 years, had a great husband, and then he left. And then when he left, he took my kids, my 3 kids. And then on top of that, they foreclosed my home. They took my car. And then I lost my job after that. And you know, I was best lawyer in town. Everybody wanted me as their lawyer. And now I'm working here with these busted old fireworks that could blow up any minute.
You know, sometimes we go through things to see what we're going to do. If we're going to trust in God or fall down. And sometimes when we're going through those trials, it gets difficult. And you know what? What may be difficult to you may be simple to me. But what I'm going through may be terrible for me. And you're like, please, I can go through that with my eyes closed. But the thing is, when you hold out for God, He's going to hold you up. Every time you feel like you're falling down. I'm sure you used to read the Bible and pray when you were in church, right?
Well, yeah. I had to read the Bible and pray.
But did you ever want to?
Yes. I loved doing it. I loved going to church. I loved going to Bible study. I loved it all. And then all of a sudden, just within a snap, everything was gone. And so now, I don't know what else to do. I prayed, I seek, and I've asked, and I get nothing. Nothing but silence.
Have you ever just waited?
Well, I think 3 years of waiting is long enough, don't you think?
Sometimes 3 years isn't enough for God. And I know it's difficult. I know. You know, just like when I was going through school, it took me 9 years to get a 4-year degree. So some things, it takes a while.
Yeah. You're right. Some things do take a while. But I have another question up. Because you're always talking about how Jesus loves us. If Jesus loved us so much, then why is there so much raping going on? So much killing? So much thieving? I mean, take a look around. It's a lot going on.
But you know, God never said it was going to be an easy life. He told us we were going to have trials that we went through. All of us. His thing is that He's there to support us as we go through those trials. You know, and I even have days that are bad. I have days when I get frustrated, and I have days when I may not say the nicest thing or be the nicest person, but you know, the great thing is God, He forgives us. He allows us to just kind of say, okay, I screwed up. Can you forgive me? And He takes us right back with open arms. And I guarantee you, no matter how far you think you are from God, He's just standing there waiting for you to call on Him, waiting for you to come back to Him, waiting for His lost sheep to return. Now, you be careful now, because you kind of are getting those screwed up a little.
I know what I'm doing.
Okay, well, I'm just saying.
Yeah, I know. I got it.
Okay. Well, I'm going to go ahead and start getting ready for the end of day, and I'll see you on Sunday, maybe?
Sunday. I'll be there.
Okay. Just look for Cox. We're right across the street from Cox, okay?
I got you.
Okay. Well, I'll be praying for you, okay?
Okay. Thank you.
Uh-huh.
I think it's funny that people can always sit around and say, yeah, I understand. Going through school is nothing compared to what I went through. The heartbreak and the loss, and it's just stressful. And she really doesn't understand how stressful this is. When you go from a big hotshot lawyer to a little firework worker and making fireworks for a living at only $7.25 an hour, that's not getting by. It's not cutting it. But I guess she does have a point, though. Maybe I should go back to church. Just one time. But I don't know. I guess I gotta hurry up and go, though.
I'm gonna be late.
Guess I need to put this firework together too. Spence just said it was inspection day. I guess the black cord goes with this gray cord, right?
No.
Courtney!
Oh my God.
Oh my, let me call 911. I'll go count. Yes, we've had an accident here.
Oh my gosh.
Hallway. I can hear their footsteps. She told me of this hell. She called it the lake of fire. I can't stand it. I'm terrified. The angels are at the door. Oh no. No, they are carrying me in and they are pointing at me. They are grabbing me and carrying me out of the room. I can already smell the burning sulfur and brimstone.
Yeah.
I can see the edge of the cliff where the hell burns. I'm without hope. This is it. We are coming closer. Closer. My heart is bursting with fear. They are holding me over the flames. I'm doomed forever. This is it. They are throwing me in. Fire. Pain. Hell. Why? Why didn't I ever listen about Jesus?
Just so then I can.
Let's go. Back to yourself.
Move it. Please, can I go back? Move it. Please, can I please go? I just want to go back. Please, just as a caterpillar, maybe a butterfly. Please, just so then I can warn other people that they don't want to be here. You get no water. You get no food. You don't get anything. You don't do nothing but burn. Burn, and you get tortured. For the rest of your life, you don't want to be here. If you only listen to God, listen to that Beth. I have that Beth, and I never listen to her. If you have that Beth that's in your life, you need to listen to it. And you need to give your life over to God. Only God can save you from here. You don't want to come here.
You know what? You block demons.
No. No, I don't want to go. No. No, please. No, I don't want to be here. No. Let me go, please.
Because if you have done this for me, then again, it's not, it's well, my home, and I love it, but there is no God, every TV turn on, every billboard, you see my name, right?
Said some vital things to his believers. He said, if you believe in me, I'm going to prepare a place for you, that where I am, there ye may be also, and where I go, ye know, and the way you know. David said this, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I'll fear no evil. Why? Because thou art with me. Thou art with me. There was a question asked to Jesus, asked to the disciples. Who do men say that I am? Some thought he was a great prophet. Some thought he was Elisha. Some thought it was even a resurrected John the Baptist. He said to his disciples, but who do you say? Who do you say that I am? And it was a quietness, because that question went to each one individual. Finally, Peter spoke up and he said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. He said, Jesus said to him, upon this rock, on this truth, I'm going to build my church, and the very gates of hell shall not prevail. You don't have to be intimidated. You don't have to fear. Praise God. You don't have to be worried about the other side. All you have to say is, be gone. Have the strength and the power to say, be gone. Satan, be gone. Just at the name of Jesus, the Bible says the demons flee. Amen.
Amen.
Be gone. Said, I prepared a place for you, that where I am, there ye may be also. Praise God. And this is what we look forward to. A lot of evil influences. But there is a greater power than any evil influence that's out there. That power is found in Christ. We dramatize this today to let those know, praise God, that there's another way. So many times, just like in the play, just like in the skit, in the drama, people take things for granted. But you don't have to take Christ for granted. You can know beyond the shadow of a doubt where you're going. Praise God. And I always say, and we close this play with these words, is anybody out there that really don't know him? There's nothing to be embarrassed about. Praise God. Nothing to say, well, I can do it another time. I remember in my mind, I used to say that as a teenager. I can do it at another time. But the Bible says, today, now, today is the day of salvation. As we're seeing in that drama. Praise God. Amen. We can have that confidence, even right now. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let's give him a hand on the day. Amen, amen. Appreciate it.